Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, we're gonna look at why you might need a gateway for a cloud data source. Does that even make sense? Power BI is in the cloud too. Why can't they? Let's take a look. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. Cloud data sources, what do I even mean by that? So this could be Azure SQL Database, Azure Analysis Services, maybe something that's in Google's cloud or Amazon's cloud, just a data source that resides in one of those big three cloud infrastructures of some kind. Let's take Azure SQL Database as an example. They're both in Microsoft's data center. And so you would think if I've got an Azure SQL Database, I can just connect using Power BI without needing anything. They're both in the cloud, like they're both in Azure. The challenge is network security and the network path. Can they talk to each other? So enough all this talking. You know how we like to do it here in Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. So I've got a data set that's up in the Power BI service itself. We can see here that my data source name is my AdventureWorks and it's sitting on gicdemodata.database.windows.net. It's just an Azure SQL database. And so I'm just gonna go and put in my credentials here and we'll see that we get an error, right? So it's telling me, look, this IP address isn't allowed into the actual database and you gotta go run some firewall rules. If your organization is serious about security, at the minimum, they've probably got a firewall sitting right there. So they're not just gonna let anyone connect to the database, right? You've gotta be on an approved list. But what about Power BI? Power BI is not part of my local network subnet or coming from my IP. And so how do I get Power BI to actually be allowed to connect to this database? Most data sources will have this option from an Azure perspective where I can just say allow Azure services and all resources. I can save that. Power BI should be covered by this. I will put a disclaimer that not every single thing will or will not be in this list. So it may or may not work depending on what you're dealing with. For Azure SQL Database, this should work. So let's go ahead and try this again. Bam. And now I'm in. I've allowed Power BI to actually use this data source, at which point I can go and refresh my database and everything will be fine. So let's try it again. Bam, it succeeded. What if your data source is in a different cloud? Again, it's a network path thing. Can Power BI talk to that data source? And the answer there is gonna be no if there's some firewall or something in place in that other cloud provider. And so we need a gateway to go do that. And you can configure the gateway to use those cloud sources in most cases. Let me talk about the most common thing that I see when talking to customers. From the Azure side of this, it's going to be a VNet or virtual network. I have Azure SQL Database that's also within side of a VNet. And from that perspective, it can't connect directly. There is no direct endpoint. I've actually disabled public access to this database. It can only be connected to from the private endpoint. So let's take a look at that. So I've got this data set that is published and it's connecting to the Azure SQL Database that's inside of the virtual network. And we can see here, it's a different server name. So let me go and edit credentials here. We'll do OAuth. And we'll see here that we get an error basically saying, look, we've denied public network access. Power BI cannot get to this. This one's a little different because it's not a firewall rule. It's not like I can go just check allow Azure services to connect. That won't work here because it's in a virtual network. There is no public access allowed. And Power BI is by default going to be coming in through that public endpoint. And in this case, we've got two options here. One is I can actually use the on-premises data gateway in a virtual machine that's inside of that virtual network. The other option we have is the VNet gateway that's available through Power BI as well. And I can allow that VNet gateway to be a part of the VNet that the SQL database is inside of as well. And that's actually what I've done in this case. Let's look. We'll go to gateway and I'll choose on-premises data gateway. And you'll see I've got this GIC VNet Power Platform VNet gateway. So that's what that icon is. It's an actual VNet gateway. And I've configured my data source there. Let's go and apply that. And now if I come back and refresh, there it is. It worked successfully. And let me know in the comments if you want a video on like how to even set up the VNet gateway. There are some steps to get that going and some of it is not necessarily intuitive, right? It's Azure networking. And so the big thing here is the network path itself. Power BI has to be able to connect to that data source. And so without a gateway, there's no other way for Power BI to talk to it. It's gotta be public access points. And most organizations lock that down. And they won't allow that because it's not a secure approach for data sources, right? There's hackers out there. There's malicious intent folks that want to get to your data. And so you want to have something in play that protects the data. Typically, that's why organizations disable public access, and you have to go through specific network routes to get there. Let's say you're using Snowflake that's in AWS, or you're using BigQuery that's in Google Cloud. In those cases, if you're using like a VPC or virtual private cloud on either Google or Amazon, there's no way for Power BI to directly integrate with that, right? So we have the VNet gateway, but that's specific to Azure. There is nothing for Google Cloud or AWS. And so in that case, no matter what you do, you're going to need the on-premises data gateway sitting in a VM or a bare metal machine somewhere that's actually running. And that's how Power BI is going to be able to get to your data. Now, you can place that VM anywhere, right? In Google's cloud itself or in AWS's cloud, and it's sitting there and it has access to that database. Or I've seen organizations where they have network routes in place that go through their actual physical corporate network, a VPN of some kind. Then from the gateway has to have network access to the data source. So that's the big thing here you got to remember is, can I physically talk to that data source from a network perspective? If the answer is no, then you got to get a gateway in place. I know it's a complex topic, but there are options for you to get this to work. All right, I want to hand this over to you. What do you think? Have you struggled with understanding some of these network concepts? Or are you wondering like why you just can't use your cloud data source directly with Power BI? Maybe this helped you. Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.